So, John, y'all have done some amazing things in North Carolina. We've touched on a few of those. But I know there's a lot of people all throughout the country that would also like to put in place some things to get around this unconstitutional Reconstruction Act and start gaining their freedom back as well. So could you walk us through a little bit about what they might do and any more things that you'd like to talk about North Carolina?
Well, to me, this is the most exciting part of it, because Americans right now feel like their hands are tied, that the only way to change anything is to vote for people in this system. Oh, we just got to get politically active. We've seen that voting has failed. And it's like, so what do we do? Well, we can't vote. It's, hey, let's do what our founders did. Let's put it back in the hands of the people. The people of every state. This is an unconstitutional act. You got to remember, the states that are in place that they want to vote in and hopefully get change out of, they're usurpations. They're the result of a usurpation. They're a result of they're created by an unconstitutional act, because all of their body politics are national citizens, not the original state citizens, what was put away by Reconstruction. So every state actually has remedy in doing what we did in North Carolina. Is number one is properly ascertain why the federal government is out of control. Is it because they're operating under the Constitution as our founders put into place and just slowly gotten away from it? Or did they overthrow it politically with the Civil War? Illegally, and if it's done illegally or unconstitutionally, we've got remedy. There is no expiration, statute of limitations on an unconstitutional act. It's still there. It's remedy, waiting for the people to pick back up. Not people to go to their representatives and try to, no, it's back in our hands. Those representatives aren't our representatives. They're the representatives of the national citizens residing in the states. We want to put back in place representatives of the free people of the United States. Let's get the free people of the United States back in having their own government and being sovereign states again. So basically, what you've got here is, what is the remedy? Because most people say, well, Reconstruction was only on the southern states. You know, these ones done by military force. And so we created three different categories of states by Reconstruction. We had the ones that were directly reconstructed by military force, those 10. Then we have the ones that, because they were forced to adopt the 14th Amendment and make it part of the National Constitution, the ones whose citizenship, as soon as the 14th Amendment was ratified, their citizenship lawfully changed from state citizens to 14th Amendment U.S. citizens. And so that's a bunch of the states right there. And then you've got the post, what about the states that came in after Reconstruction? You know, the ones that are being created by out of the territories, the Colorado, North Dakota, Montana, Hawaii, Alaska. Well, we've got the Northwest Ordinance. And the Northwest Ordinance is part of our laws, which says that these territories, once they have enough people, can organize, create a form of government, and admit that in, and then they get to come into the Union on equal footing with the original states. Well, these states, as they are now with national citizens, did not come in on equal footing with the original states. The original states came in on a footing of sovereignty of the people of that state. All of these states came into the Union as subjugated citizens subject to Congress, nationalized citizens who don't have state rights, cannot enjoy the full embodiment of the U.S. Constitution.
So in order to achieve this, what are the costs and risks to individuals in adopting this remedy?
Well, number one, this is a legal mode, legal process. We have an absolute legal right to do this. Mm-hmm. Is it scary? Is it outside the box? Absolutely. Are people going to be scared of it? Yes. But if you take counsel in your fears and do nothing, then the system just stays in place. Mm-hmm. Fear comes because this is a powerful entity. The issue is are we brave enough? Are we willing to stand up for this? Because you can only gain what you're willing to risk. If you want to gain your freedom, you have to risk your freedom by the person who wants to enslave you. And so we've got to become a people who are emboldened by the truth, by the law, who are tired of being bullied by the federal government and these laws they pass, and say, you know what, we've had enough. It's time to stand up. And that's what we're looking for, the people who say, man, I want to stand up. I want to fight for freedom in America again. And those are the people we're going at. Are there going to be fearful moments for people? Yes. Are there going to be risks? Yes. But also, you want to minimize those risks. We're not talking for people to have knee-jerk reactions. You don't have to stand up all at once. You know, you want to look at this. We want to start, and this is where a lot of discussion needs to take place of what can I do as an individual. You don't have to jump off the cliff at the very beginning.
Well, and I think that's one of the beauties of this solution. It's very elegant. One of the techniques that you use so much is it takes the burden of proof off of the individuals who are in the movement and places it back on this illegitimate government by forcing them to prove their legitimacy, and that's where it kind of breaks down. So tell the folks a little bit about how that y'all use that technique successfully in North Carolina.
Great question. So yeah, what we did by doing this, we reestablished the state. We gave notice, legal notice to the system, to I think it was Bill Clinton and Jim Hunt at the time in 1997. That we're reestablishing this. Well, now, you know, they're not going to recognize it. And so what we do is, I haven't had a driver's license in, I don't know, 18 years or so. So we get pulled over by the system and they take us into court. And our argument is they're not lawfully created, but in a good faith effort to resolve this issue, we're going to make a special appearance into court to address this just so they can prove they're a lawfully created state before they can say, I'm subject to them. I've got to have their license. I've got to do whatever they say. Because if they're an unconstitutionally created state, they're a nullity in law. I have no obligation to obey a nullity in law. So we go in there on special appearance in good faith to say, hey, this is what we've got. We think Reconstruction, how y'all were created, was unconstitutional. You're not really created in law. And if you will prove you're a lawfully created state, Reconstruction was lawful, it was constitutional, Congress had the power to do it, then I will get your license. I will do whatever you say, because then you're a legal entity. But if you're not a legal entity, you're nothing more than organized crime. You know, that's all you are. And you're just going to bully people into obeying you, not proving in law that people are required to obey you. So we go in there, challenge jurisdiction, and think about this. And basically we've been met with, they will never do it. They refuse to prove they're lawfully created. And this should be disturbing to every American, mm-hmm. especially in Georgia, North Carolina. You go in, if you will prove you're lawfully created, I will do whatever you want. Mm-hmm. And if you have an entity that says, we refuse to prove it, and how many times do they have to prove it? Once. All they got to do is prove it one time. And then we recognize them, and this movement that we're talking about here goes away. We have no legal foundation, but we're going to stand on our legal foundation and challenge them, keep going at them, go at them, be tenacious.
And of course you have briefs and so on to do that as well. And I think that's one of the beauty of this particular solution is so elegant that it shifts the burden of proof from the citizen who's trying to get their rights back onto this illegitimate government, and you're forcing them to attempt to prove something that they know they cannot prove, which is their own legitimacy. So that's, I think, probably one of the most elegant solutions I've ever seen. John, we're about out of time, so would you like to say in closing in any other different aspects that we may not have touched on yet?
Well, what I'd like to say in closing is, again, the beauty of this. All it takes is people know the system we have in place doesn't go by the law, doesn't recognize the Constitution, operating totally outside. We're asking people to, well, if it's not lawful, all you have to do is start doing, hey, I got an idea. Let's start doing what we know is lawful. The original body politics are lawful. I'm going to start it's not up to them to prove they're lawful. It's up to me to start doing what is right. So it's up to the people of America to start doing what is right, participate in what you know is lawful, rather than being confused in this entity that's not lawful. Reestablish your states. You know, let's get freedom back in America again. That's what that's what this whole movement is about. Let's free America. Get it out from underneath congressional control.
So folks, there's your solution. It's very simple and it's very elegant. If you're tired of the federal government national government, being totally out of control, you now have a chance to do something about it. And it's low risk and it's low cost. So check out americasremedy.com and John Ainsworth, and you'll find all the information that you need up there. Thanks for watching this.